afternoon baseball from Wrigley Field in Chicago. Today, we'll see a contest from the National League Central between the St. Louis Cardinals and the Chicago Cubs.
And now, your 2000.
It's baseball on MLB Network,
Chicago,
and it's coming up next. So now into the box is Tommy Edman. He will lead this one off today. The 1-2. And just a Chamber of Commerce afternoon for baseball. 82 degrees here at first pitch. And he pops him up, drifting toward the left side of the infield. And there's out number one. So next to hit is Edmundo Sosa.
Edmundo.
One out, nobody on. That's right there at the belt, 1-2 now.
Hey, boys, he's lucky he's getting his pitch back right here. That's normally a wipeout pitch down and away. He hung that one. It looked like he almost confused the hitter.
So he punches him out looking at the fastball. Edmundo Sosa goes down for out number two in the top half. Liner toward right center. And this is going to find the seam in right center and should get to the ivy for extra bases. And he'll make it to second base now with two gone.
That is good. The left field, Tyler.
In now, Tyler O'Neill. Strike two taken. The fastball that clips the inside black.
Hey, I know we're only in the top of the first, but back-breaking blows are those two out, runners in scoring position knocks, and they have a chance to capitalize right here.
Boy, Dero, you touched on it right there. I think as a pitcher, you try to get through that first inning and not have to show all of your pitches and empty out the bucket. That two-out double right now, he's going to have to buckle down to try to keep this game scoreless.
The 2-2 pitch. Chopped toward the second baseman. And nothing will come of the two-out double as the inning is over. Now into the box, number 66. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. Hot shot down the line, but this will get foul. It's a ball and two strikes.
The offensive game plan today is certainly to see the ball up. This guy is known on the mound for sinker changeup combination. He's going to try and establish down in the zone to get swing and a miss or ground balls consistently. You have to find something above the belt to get loose on.
The first baseman, number
at the plate now, number 18. He swings and misses, throw down. And it'll be right on the bag as Molina nails him trying to swipe second. A 1-2. Bat explodes as this has popped up. And he'll whip this one over to first, and he gets his man for the second out. Next, it'll be Ian Happ. No one aboard for him, and two gone here in the first. Now the 1-1 pitch. Bases are empty here with two men out. Lays off, 2-2 now.
Pretty good breaking ball to lay off of right there. If I'm pitching, I might think this guy might be sitting on something off speed.
Swing and a laser off into foul territory. Fouled away. Here's another 2-2. And he misses this one inside, and that'll run things full, 3-2.
Hey, this guy's a hard guy to put away. He's fouling off some tough pitches. 2-2 count, and he just seems to keep hanging right in there.
Another full count pitch home. High in the air out to center field. Bader finds some space out there for the catch to retire the side. Here's Nolan Arenado as it'll be 5, 6, and 7 due up to kick off the second inning. And it's fouled away. And that's low, so a good eye there as he works the count back full.
Well, you don't see it all that often, but this might be a good time for a 3-2 change. If he can locate it, it's nearly impossible to hit.
Another payoff pitch. Fouled off. Still 3-2. The eighth pitch of the at-bat. And he could only battle for so long as he's finally set down here after an 8-pitch at-bat. Stepping in next, Harrison Bader. Fly ball out toward left center field. Center fielder on the run. He tracks it down and makes the play to record the second out. So the bases are empty with two gone now. And here now is the catcher, Yadier Molina. Fastball, and looks like they're pinching him a bit here. It's 3-1.
So that's two pitches in a row above the belt. As a hitter, that's what you're looking for, especially when it's a day game and the ball is carried. That just wasn't a good enough pitch to hit.
Dylan Carlson.
Here now the 2-2 is a swing and a miss. That's strike three. Bottom of the inning now, and digging in is the big-time power threat, Wilson Contreras. 1-1 on its way from Lester.
2-1.
Swung on and lifted in the air to left center. Chasing after it is O'Neill. He gets there to make the play for the first out of the inning. Kwangyoung Kim comes in unexpectedly from the pen in relief of his injured teammate. So next to bat will be Patrick Wisdom. Bottom of the second here with no score. And this ball runs away for ball two. 2-1. All even now, 2-2. And good patience to hold back on the curveball in the dirt. It's full now, 3-2. Matt Duffy waits on deck. Did a good job to shorten up and protect the plate, and he'll have another shot at it here. And another foul ball.
You can really tell they're trying to keep the ball in on this big slugger right here.
Is that an effort to keep him from getting extended, do you think?
Yeah, I think that's the idea, Matt. But he might spin to win if he starts looking for it in there.
Lifted in the air out towards left center. Bader is there now, and he has it. Two gone. Into the box, Matt Duffy will try to make something happen with two gone in the bottom of the second. Two out, nobody on. Two balls and two strikes to Duffy.
Well, two straight fastballs inside haven't put him away. So now it'll be interesting to see what he turns to.
Now a curveball in there. Strike three called, and the inning is over. And now here is Kwangyoung Kim as we are all set to begin the third inning in this one. Now the 1-1 pitch is swung on and missed for strike number two.
The offense better get it going right here, because they certainly can tell from their dugout this guy is carrying himself with a presence out on the mound. He's got feel for all his pitches.
Swing and a liner. Number 66 is there, and he makes the catch for the out. So one gone here in the St. Louis third, and that'll bring in Tommy Edman. Now here's the pitch. Into center field, line drive, base hit.
Now batting, shortstop, Edmundo Sosa.
Here's a look over to first, and he's back standing. Edman, base runner at first with one out. And another throw over, and he'll get dirty, but he's back in safely. So now to the plate, Edmundo Sosa. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike. Three balls and a strike to the Cardinals shortstop.
That's a great call right there. Fastball away with a guy who's got some jets on first base. Almost like a hybrid pitch out. Great for a catcher if that guy's wrong.
And hold on there. That's not going to get him in there with the stolen base. Now the 3-2 pitch, swing and a liner. But this will hang up just enough as he takes it in stride in left center for the second out. Here's Paul Goldschmidt now. One for one as he reached base with a double his first time up.
Well, he got a good pitch to hit last time up. Looked for it up in the zone and didn't miss it. Those are the pitches you only get maybe once in a...
This ball gets down. Let's see if they try to score. And they're not going to get him. He's in there at the plate. At the plate, Tyler O'Neill skied into straightaway right. Hayward has a read on it, and he's got it for the final out of the frame. Ready to go for the last half of the inning, and that'll bring up the multi-gold glover, Jason Hayward. Still 1-2 as he fouls it away. Counts even to Hayward, two balls and two strikes.
We just saw a fastball right there. I would not be shocked if he tries to get this guy to go fishing right here and drops a little off-speed pitch in the dirt.
Full count, 3-2. Now the payoff pitch home. And good patience exercised as he works out the walk to lead off the home half of the third.
Batting it.
Next up, Sergio Alcantara. The 1-1 pitch. A ball and two strikes now. And a breaking ball in the dirt that time for a ball. Down the left field line and deep, but this is going to wind up a foul ball. Now a good pitch around the knees, but it doesn't quite catch the bottom of the zone. Still hanging with him. Another good swing to keep it going. And he lays off there, ball four. So back-to-back walks have him in business here with nobody out. Next to hit will be the pitcher, number 56. First trip to the plate for him in the ballgame. And no surprise to see the pitcher squaring around as he gets this one down. There's one. Relay to Goldie, and that gets him as well, a double play. So the next to bat will be number 66. Runner in scoring position with two gone. Now here's a comebacker back to the mound. And he'll flip this one on to first as he works his way out of the jam, and the inning is over. Set for the start of the inning, and in next it'll be the perennial MVP candidate, third baseman Nolan Arenado. Grounded to the right, and that is through into right field for a single.
the center field. Harrison Bader.
To the plate now, Harrison Bader. Swung on, but it's pulled foul wide of third.
Hey, usually the second time through the order, you start seeing an incorporation of some more off-speed stuff. But this guy's locating, feeling.
Now, meanwhile here, this ball's hit fairly well down that left field line, and it's going to stay fair. It's a home run. Into the box, Yadier Molina. And he misses again, ball three. Fastball is taken for a strike, and he runs it full, 3-2.
Four-seam heater right down the middle. I would have thought he popped a clutch on that pitch.
And there's a line drive, base hit to left field.
The right fielder, number three, Dylan Carlson.
Into the box now, Dylan Carlson, hit down the third baseline. Hoping to send him packing, pitch on its way. Molina aboard here at first with nobody out. So a full count now. And that misses for ball four. And it's first and second now with nobody out. Adbert Alzale answers the call from the pen here in the fourth as they didn't get the outing they were hoping for from their starter. Kwangyoung Kim will be his first test out of the bullpen, and it'll be a tough test indeed as he'll face him with two on and nobody out here. Three runs, six hits, and no errors so far for the Redbirds. And a bunt attempt here with two strikes that'll get foul, so he'll become out number one. That brings in Tommy Edman. He reached on a single last time and later wound up scoring.
Yeah, and they take another single right here. That third base coach is dying to wave his arms. I wouldn't be surprised if anything hit hard through the infield, he's going to wave them.
One there, but they won't get two as he beats the relay to first. Digging in next, Edmundo Sosa.
The shortstop, Edmundo Sosa.
Timing just to tick off there as this one's fouled off to the right. The 2-2 one more time. And he misses this one inside, and that'll run things full, 3-2.
3-2, two out, runner on first. Lots of possible outcomes on this pitch.
And that is through into center field, a base hit. They'll cash in here as the run is in to score from third. That makes it a 4-0 ball game.
The first baseman, Paul Goldschmidt.
Stepping in now, Paul Goldschmidt. And he fouls this one off. High in the air down the right field line. On the move is Hayward. He tracks it down, and that will end the inning. Now it'll be number 18. Comes into this at bat 0-for-1 in the ballgame.
They've gotten a gut punch to start this game. There's no doubt about this, but that's when you have to turn the scoreboards off. Everybody do their job one at bat at a time.
The count now at 2-1. Three balls and a strike to the Chicago leadoff hitter. Ian Happ waits on deck. Sent on the ground out to second. Scooped up, and there's one away. Striding in is Ian Happ. He flew out in his last AB. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. Hit out towards second. He's got it. And there are two away now. Here's the young catcher, Wilson Contreras.
The catcher.
No runs, just one hit. No errors so far for the Cubbies. Clearly off with his timing on that one, a swinging strike.
That swing looked kind of out of control to me. Looked like he was trying to dial nine, but when you're down by four runs early in the game, that doesn't make a whole lot of sense.
The next 3-2. He swung on and missed. He got him on strikes. Now the Cardinals' number four hitter, Tyler O'Neill. He'll start off the fifth in this one. The 3-1. And a good eye here as he takes ball four, and it's a base on balls to lead off the fifth inning. Next to hit, Nolan Arenado singled in his last at-bat. Softly hit down to third, likely no shot at two. The second for one, on to first, and they get them both. Base is empty, two away, and into bat next, one of the fastest players in all of baseball, Harrison Bader. 1-1. Fouled away. Another 1-2 delivery.
Ball, that's down.
And this is where he's especially dangerous, because if you walk him, he can steal a base on you. But if you lay a fastball in there, he can take you deep, too.
And this one misses here. A close pitch on 3-2, but Clyde Washington rules it ball four. Now the 1-1 pitch. Taken, strike two. Little slide step action there, Dan.
Yeah, he's clearly thinking about the steal right here. Didn't happen, but the cat-mouse game continues on.
2-2 to the Cardinals catcher.
I'll tell you, it's a helpless feeling for a manager or a pitching coach when your pitchers are having a really hard time throwing strikes.
And he's in the second safely with a stolen base. He's set. Here's the 3-2. Swing and a high fly ball out to left field. A ball that's carrying. On the warning track, he makes the catch. Now at the plate, here is Patrick Wisdom as we move past the halfway point in this one and begin the bottom of the fifth. Two and two. Turned on that one and crushed it. Just pulled it a little foul. The 2-2. Again, he sends it out of play. The 2-2. And he's getting his money's worth up there now. It's full 3-2.
You can certainly tell at bats like this one frustrate the heck out of a pitcher. But you got to find a way to stay composed and execute your plan.
The next 3-2. And he popped him up. And Goldschmidt able to put the squeeze on it here. One away. The next Cub up, Matt Duffy, 0-for-1, went down looking his first time up.
Yeah, in today's game, certainly don't get completely reprimanded for too many strikeouts, but no one likes to go down looking. Expect him to be a little bit more aggressive at the dish this AB.
Now the 2-1 pitch. Bases are empty, one man out. On a good changeup, a swing and a miss, and he's set down on strikes for the second time today.
The right fielder.
So stepping in is Jason Hayward. He drew a base on balls his first time up. High and deep down the left field line, and it's a foul ball.
Well, somebody's sitting off speed right here. Only way he was late on that heater is he was expecting another changeup.
And this will get through into right, and he's aboard with a single.
Now batting, shortstop, Sergio.
In now, Sergio Alcantara. And this pitch misses for ball four. So that's going to move a runner into scoring position now with two away. Lofted in the air out toward right center. And no trouble for him as he makes the catch to end the inning. Trevor McGill takes over to start the sixth inning on the mound. Top half of the sixth about to get started, and set to go is the switch hitting outfielder Dylan Carlson. Here comes the payoff pitch. Rolled slowly to first, right to him, and he'll step on first for the out, three unassisted.
Lars Nootbaar steps into the on deck circle now, looking to start something here with one gone in the inning.
One out, nobody on. That's strike two on a well placed changeup around the knees.
He'll be fine coming out of the bullpen in this one if he can keep the ball around the knees like that.
Here's a swing and a high pop-up. And that'll take care of the pinch hitter here for out number two. So two gone now in the St. Louis half of the sixth, and that'll bring in Tommy Edmond. Now the 2-1. Sent in the air out to straightaway center. He's under it, and that ends the inning. T.J. McFarland enters to do the pitching in the bottom of the sixth. Now back to the top of the lineup, stepping in number 66. One for two on his line so far in the game. Swung on and lifted in the air to left center. Center fielder giving chase. He makes the play. A fine running catch to get the first out of the inning. Digging in will be number 18. He comes in 0 for 2 thus far. Bases are empty, one man out. Hit sharply on the ground to the left. And a base hit into left field, so they've got themselves a one out base runner.
The left fielder, number 8, Ian.
At the plate, Ian Happ. Takes this the other way to right, and that's in there, base hit. And that runner will hold up at second with two aboard now.
The catcher, number 40, Wilson.
So now to the plate, Wilson Contreras. Swing and a miss, and they'll dodge a major bullet that time. Two away. Next, 16. It'll be Patrick Wisdom, flew out last time up. The 2-2 doesn't get the zone, count full now.
Well, the tying run looms on deck, so keeping this guy off the base is essential. In danger of walking him right here, though.
On to first, and the Cubs squander what looked like a good opportunity as that ends the inning. Stepping in for the Cardinals, Edmundo Sosa delivered an RBI single last time up. Into the windup, here's the 2-1 pitch. Lifted in the air out towards left center. Happ arranged to his left as he tracks this one down in left center for the first out. Next to dig in, Paul Goldschmidt, 2 for 3 with a double on his line so far. One out, nobody on. 1-2 now as that one's fouled off. Good plate discipline to lay off the slider that time, and he draws even at 2-2.
And a swing and a miss here, so it's a quick two outs to start the seventh. So now it'll be the four-hole hitter, Tyler O'Neill. It was a walk in his last trip. Slider laid off for a ball. Bases are empty here with two men out. 2-2.
When I broke into the league, not many guys were throwing that elevated fastball with that much velocity on it. The game has changed.
And the inning goes away in unceremonious fashion on a swing and a miss at a ball way outside the strike zone. And stepping in, Matt Duffy. He'll be the man to lead things off here in the bottom of the seventh. The 1-1 home. Hit in the air down the right field line. Right fielder giving chase, and he tracks it down. Nice play for the first out. So one away in the inning, and that'll bring in the dangerous bat of Jason Hayward, the right fielder. Look into Molina, now the 1-1. And he hammers it to deep right field. Into the bleachers, and gone! Alex Reyes takes the call from the pen as he'll try to get the final two outs of this seventh frame. Into the box, Sergio Alcantara, Cubs shortstop with a 3-1 count. His career line against Reyes, not a big sample size, 0-1. Pulled toward right center field. Carlson is over to his right as he puts this one away. Two down. Number 62 will get the call here as he'll hit for the pitcher.
Pinch hitting for the Cubs. Number 62.
Two out, nobody on. And he lays off. Ball four. So he comes right off the bench and works the walk. Usually easier said than done.
Number 66.
So in now for Chicago. Number 66. He's working on a 1-for-3 thus far. The 2-1 home.
Well, tying run on deck. He should get something really good to hit right here in a 3-1 count. I'd be sitting on a fastball middle in.
And he misses again. Ball four. And that's back-to-back guys now that have reached base via the base on balls.
Number 18.
Next up is number 18. Two outs and two runners aboard here in the seventh inning. Full count now. 3-2. Skied into straightaway right. Right fielder is on the run. He makes the catch. What a play on the run to end the inning. Dylan Maples has been summoned from the bullpen as he'll do so to start the eighth. Ready to begin the eighth and set to go as the third baseman, Nolan Arenado. Strike three called on the fastball, one gone. And that'll bring up the former top prospect, Harrison Bader. He comes in 1-for-2 with that home run he hit earlier. He's set. Here's the 3-2. And he makes good contact there, but this is going to find the stands foul down the right field line. Another full count pitch home. He is swung on and missed. He got him on strikes. The next to bat for St. Louis, Yadier Molina, trying to avoid becoming the third strikeout victim of the inning here. 3-2 pitch. Line shot to second, but it's caught and the side is retired. Andrew Miller will come on now and he'll slide into the seventh spot in the lineup following the double switch. Andrew Kisner will also come on now as he'll move into the pitcher's number 9 hold in the order here on that double switch. The 1-1.
This is why the manager pencils these guys in the middle of the order. Big spot, time for them to get back in this game with a couple quality ABs.
Good swing on a tough pitch, and he'll stick around to see another one. A ball and two strikes, here it is. Is a wave and a miss, he struck him out. So one gone here in the Chicago eighth. And stepping up to hit next, the catcher Wilson Contreras. Now the 1-1 pitch. Popped into the air, back behind second. Edmund is right there. Two gone. Next to hit is Patrick Wisdom. Only four outs remaining for them to try and rally back in this one. The 1-1 is a slider taken for a ball.
Boy, that's one of the toughest pitches to lay off. A hard breaking ball at the back foot. Tough take on a terrific pitch.
And it's two balls and two strikes now. The 2-2 is swung on and missed. He got him on strikes. All set to start the ninth in this one. And digging in is the outfielder, Dylan Carlson. Two balls and a strike to the St. Louis leadoff hitter. Skied in the air to straightaway left. Half has him played perfectly as he puts it away for out number one. Ready now is Andrew Kisner.
Andrew.
Bases are empty, one man out. And it's 3-2 now to the number nine hitter.
You could pretty much book it that a fastball's coming. A challenge fastball right here. He cannot allow the nine-hole hitter to get on base with the top of the order looming.
And that's into the outfield for a one-out base hit.
Up next to the Cardinals, the second baseman.
Into the box now, Tommy Edman. This one's flared out toward left. Left fielder coming in. He can't get there as it falls in.
Now batter, the shortstop, Edmundo Sosa.
Stepping in now, Edmundo Sosa. Oh, a fastball swung on and missed, and for the second time today, he's gone on strikes.
Up next to the target.
And that brings up Paul Goldschmidt. He's doubled and singled in four at-bats in this contest. Slider clocked in the mid-80s there. It's a ball and two strikes.
Hey, this is a big pitch right here. Can't allow them to attack on any more runs. Let's see if he attacks his own or buries something in the dirt.
And he struck him out. So a good pitch there, and now they're going to need to string some hits together in this last at-bat if they want to get back in this thing. Giovanni Gallegos enters the game to finish this one off here in the bottom of the ninth. All set for the bottom of the ninth. And set to go is the second baseman, Matt Duffy.
Hey, not impossible, but highly improbable. Even when you're at home to score three runs off a closer like this guy, they've got the work cut out for him.
Down the left field line and deep. And it's a foul ball. And could this be the start? It's a long way back, but the leadoff man is on base to start their final set of at-bats. Pulled toward right center field. Center fielder giving chase. He makes the catch. A great effort to get there and record the first out of the inning. Stepping up is Sergio Alcantara. It was a flyout for him in his last trip. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike. And it's belted high and deep into right center. And that ball gets down out near the wall and should be extra bases. Duffy rounds the corner and is headed home. Throw won't get him. Austin Romine will be called upon here to hit with the game on the line. Did well just to make contact there as he spoils off a good changeup. Grounded back up the middle. And that is through for a base hit. And the move to the bench will pay off handsomely.
Number 66.
At the plate now, number 66. Tries to change up on him there, but it's a ball, 2-1.
Hey, this isn't going to be an easy save. These guys are making it work for this one.
And he gets a piece of this one to foul it toward the backstop. Slowly hit to first. I don't think they can get two. To second for one. Back to first. It's a double play. Right when he needed it. And this ball game is over. A one-run finish, 4-3, the final tally today. St. Louis led this game from the third inning on and never wavered. Kwangyoung Kim gets the W on the mound. Number 56 worked only three innings in the losing effort. So that just about does it for Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney down on the field, and the rest of our crew. I'm Matt Vasgersian. Thanks for watching MLB Network.
Final line score this afternoon. First for the victorious St. Louis Cardinals, 4 runs on 9 hits. No errors. They left 8 men on base.